Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh dan salam sejahtera. Okay, so now today we learn about discounting promissory notes. Okay, so what is discounting promissory note? Okay, so the holder of the promissory note need cash before the maturity date. So what the holder do? Okay, so the holder will selling the note to the bank before maturity date. Okay. Okay, so kalau tak faham, okay, so Ali ni, okay, so Ali dia ada promissory note. Okay, so last time we learn about the promissory note, which is a written document from the borrower to the lender. Okay, so this one Ali ni lender lah. Okay, so ada seseorang dia pinjam duit Ali dan dia bagi satu surat janji kepada Ali. Okay, so Ali have the promissory note. Okay, so the maturity of the promissory note, let's say is 31 June 2020. Okay, so the maturity date of the promissory note is end of June. Okay, so bermaksud pada 31 hari bulan 6 2020 ni Ali baru dapat duit dia semula daripada orang yang pinjam duit dia. But before the maturity date, which is 31 June 2020, so Ali need money. Okay, so Ali memerlukan duit. Okay, so ni masa ni mudah ni mas, apa ni, bulan 6 hari tu PKP kan, belum kan, ke dah lepas. Okay, so masa tu ramai orang tak ada kerja apa semua. So kat sini Ali ada promissory note lah. Okay, so before 31 June 2020 he need money. Okay, so in order to survive, so what he will do? So Ali will sell the promissory note to the bank. Okay, so Ali akan jual dia punya promissory note ni kepada bank dan bank akan bagi dia duit dengan menggunakan bank discount. Okay, so terms in discounting promissory note. Okay, so we have the discount date. Okay, so discount date ni the date the note is discounted. Okay, so masa Ali jual promissory note ni lah, so itu adalah discount date ni. Proceed the amount received after the note is discounted. Okay, so selepas dia jual note tu kepada bank, so dia akan dapat proceed, dia akan dapat duit. Okay, so proceed of a promissory note is computed as follow. Okay, so proceed is equal to maturity value minus by bank discount lah. So calculation dia gunakan bank discount. Okay, formula bank discount. Okay, so proceed H. Okay, so hari tu pakai simbol H kan. So H proceed. Okay. Okay, so this is the illustration of discounting a promissory note. Okay, okay, so here date of the note, macam kisah tadi, kawan Ali pinjam duit dekat sini lah. And then his member give the promissory note to the Ali. Okay, so in this time, during this time interval until here, before the maturity date, suddenly Ali need money. Okay, so in order to survive, to pay loan or whatever, right? Okay, so here Ali will discount the note to the bank. And then the bank calculate the proceed for the Ali. Okay, so berapa proceed yang akan Ali terima. Okay, so the proceed that will calculated by bank is based on the maturity value. Okay, so bank akan tengok maturity value ni dan dia akan kira proceed yang Ali akan terima. So here will become the, okay, so here will become the term of discount, tempoh masa untuk discount tu lah. Sebab daripada sini sampai sini dijual, jual promissory note tu kepada bank daripada sini, and then sampai dekat sini ujung dia. So here is the term for the promissory note. So atas ni tempoh masa untuk promissory note lah, daripada awal sampai ujung. Alright, so example. Okay, so Shahnaz held a 60-day 2100 non-interest-bearing note dated 20 July 2000. On 10 August 2000, she took the note to a finance company which discounted it at 12%. So find the maturity date. Okay, so first we find the maturity date of the note. Okay, so the note dated on 20 July. Okay, so kita kira sini month, day, and then we have baki, remainder. Okay, so we start from 60. Okay, so because the terms of the promissory note is 60 day. Okay, so for the first month we have July. Okay, so 20 July until the end of July, which is 31 minus by 20, which is equal to 11 day. And then August. Okay, so in July already 11 day. So total is 60 day. Therefore the remainder here, baki dia adalah 49. Okay, so next August, this 40 month more than 1 month. So we take full month on August. So remainder dia 49 minus 31, which is equal to 18. Okay, and then September. So here just 18, which is not more than 1 month. So therefore on September, it is only 18 day. So therefore the maturity date is equal to 18 September 2000. Okay, so 2000. Okay, so B, the term of discount. Okay, okay, so buat timeline dia. Okay, so here is the date of the note, which is wait. Okay, so here is the date of the note, which is from 20 July 2000, and then the maturity date at the end is 18 September. Okay, and then the note, she took the note to a finance company. So bila? 10 August. So 10 August, which is before 18 September. So here 10 August. So here berapa hari ni? Okay, so from 10 August until 18 September. Okay, so we need to calculate month, day. Okay, so August. Okay, so 10 August until the end of August, 31 minus 10, which is 21. And that's September. So September we only have 18 day. So total is 18 plus 21, which is 39. Okay. Okay, so therefore terms of the term of discount is 39 days. Okay, so next C, the proceeds. Okay, so proceeds, so berapa banyak dia terima duit lah. Okay, so before that, okay, so the face value of the note is 2100. Okay, and then non-interest bearing note. So non-interest bearing note meaning that R for the promissory note, interest for the promissory note is 0%. Okay, so therefore the maturity value here 2100. Okay, and then the discount rate is 12%. Okay, so D is 0.12. Okay, so 0% interest. So meaning that kawan dia pinjam 2100, kawan dia pun bayar semula 2100. But at the middle here, she need money. Okay, so dia perlukan duit dekat tengah-tengah ni. So therefore, she sell the note to the finance company in order to get some money. Okay. Okay, so kalau kita tengok tadi, okay, so kita ambil bahagian bank discount je lah. So here 10 August 2000, and here is 18 September 2000. Okay, so in order to find the proceed, okay, so the bank will calculate the proceed based on the maturity value here. Okay, so the maturity value here is 2100. Okay, to find proceed, so we use H equal to S P, not P, S 1 minus D T. Okay, so S future value, which is 2100, 1 minus D, so D which is 0.12, and T is 39 days. Okay, so 39, since the question didn't set using what, so we use the banker's rule, which is divide by 360. Okay, so the answer is, okay, so the answer is RM 2072 ringgit and 70 sen. Okay, so jawapan ke atas tu salah, so ni jawapan ni salah. Okay, so next, on 28 July 2002, Billy need cash and sold a 150-day promissory note at a 15% discount rate. Okay, so the note had a face value of 6,000, was dated on 25 June 2002, and carry an interest rate of 10%. So find the maturity value. Okay, so maturity value, okay, so kita ada note kat sini. So the face value of the note, which is 6,000, and here the maturity value is, tak tahulah sebab dia suruh cari kan. And then the term of the note is this one, 150 day. Okay, so maturity value A, S which is equal to P 1 plus RT. So R is interest rate, which is this one, 10%. So 0.1 times with 150 over 360. Okay, so the answer is RM 6250. And then B, maturity date. Okay, so maturity date, okay, so the term of the note is 150, and here the date of the note is 25 June 2002. Okay, so we start calculate from month, day, and remainder. So remainder, we have here 100, we start from 150. Okay, so month first, which is June. Okay, so for the June, 25 June until the end of June, which is 5 days. Okay, okay, so full month June is 30. January, February, March, April, May, June are 30. So 30 minus 5 is 5. So balance here 145. Okay, so 145, so more than 1 month. Okay, so we take June, July, and then August, then September. Okay, so July 31, August 31, September is 30. Okay, so total of this one is 92. So balance 145 minus 92, 3, which is 53. Okay, so still more than 1 month. So take another one, which is October. So October we have 31. So therefore balance 53 minus 31, which is 22. Okay, so after October, November. Okay, so here 22 less than 1 month. So therefore November until 22 day. So therefore date of the note, not date pula, maturity date of the note is, is equal to 22 November 2002. Okay. And then see the term of discount. Okay, so we have here start from 25 June and then end on okay, so maturity date dia 22 November. And then the Billy sold the promissory note on 28 July. So here 28 July. Okay, so di tengah-tengah antara bulan 6, 9, 11. So Billy sell the note, okay? Okay, so we need to find the term of the note, which is start from July. So Monday. Okay, so start from July, so 28 July until the end of July, so 31 minus 28, which is equal to 3. Okay, so after July, August. So August is 31. And then September, 30. October, 31. And then November, which is equal to 22. So total is equal to 1, 2, 4, 3, 7, and then 3 plus 3, 6 plus 3, 9, 9 plus 2, 11, 117 day. Okay, so therefore term of the discount is equal to 117 days. Okay, see AD proceed. Okay, so to find proceed D. Okay, so we have the maturity value, face value here. Okay, so face value is 6,000. And then maturity value dia, which is 6,250. So at the middle here, discounting. Okay. So discount rate, which is equal to 15%, 0.15. Okay, so termnya, the term is 117 D. Okay, so to find the proceed here, H is equal to S 1 minus D T. So S is 6,250. 1 minus D is 0.15 and T is 117 over 360, so which is equal to 5000 RM. So RM 5945 and 31 cent. Okay, next, so simple interest rate equivalent to bank discount rate, okay? So here, okay, so example here, when a bank use the discount method, the discount are not the interest rate, okay? So discount rate ni dia tak sama lah dengan interest rate. So interest rate we have in promissory note. Okay, so discount rate we have in bank discount, okay? So for example, dan lagi satu, maksud ayat ni, contoh dia macam tadi lah. Okay, so for example this question, so discount rate 15% and interest rate is 10%. Okay, so not equal, tak sama. Okay, so for this one, for example, Norman borrow 80,000 for 60 days at a 9% discount rate. Okay, so borrow using bank discount, therefore Norman will receive the proceed, which is 78,800. Okay, so the interest deducted in early in advance, okay? So dia tolak interest dahulu, okay? And then now sekarang, so what is the actual interest rate that is equivalent to the bank discount rate, okay? So berapakah interest rate nya setara dengan 9% bank discount ni, okay? So hence by using S equal to P 1 plus RT, okay, so 80,000, okay, so borrow 80,000, so this one at the future, and P is 78,800, okay, so dia terima. Okay, so kalau kita tengok S kat sini kan, and here is the proceed, okay. So maksudnya yang kedua ni, situasi kedua ni, kita umpamakan, kita transform kisah kat atas ni yang pertama ni menjadi kisah simple interest. Terbalikkan. So meaning that Norman borrow 78,800. So diterbalikkan juga. Diterbalikkan semula. Okay. So dia pinjam 78,800. Di at the end he 80,000. Okay. So ni maturity value. Okay, so by using simple interest calculation, so we have R equal to 9.14%. Okay, so therefore 9% discount rate this one actually is the 9.14% simple interest rate. Okay, so dia letak perkataan bank discount ni sekadar untuk mengaburi mata je lah. Oh, discount, okay, ha, boleh lah pergi sebab dapat discount. Contoh, okay. Okay, so this one formula how to find the discount rate which is equivalent to simple interest rate, and this one how to find simple interest rate which is equivalent to bank discount rate. Okay, so for example this one A, find the simple interest rate that is equivalent to the discount rate of 9% on a loan due in 60 days. Okay, so find simple interest rate, 9% is the bank discount. Okay, so therefore we use formula number 2, this one. Interest rate R. So R is equal to D, which is 0.09 divided by 1 minus 0.09. T is 60 days. So 60 divided by 360. Okay, so kita gunakan bank discount, okay. Okay, so we have R which is equal to 0.0913. Okay, so times by 100%, we have here 9.13%. Second number 2, we have R is equal to D which is 0.09 divided by okay, second. Okay, so second question, 0.105 divided by 1 minus 0.105 times by 60 over 360. Okay, so we have the answer 0.1069 times by 100%, which is equal to 10.69%. Yeah, so next B1. So find the discount rate that is equivalent to the simple interest rate of 12.5% on a loan due in 9 months. Okay, so discount rate, so we need to find the discount rate, so meaning that we use formula number 1. So D is equal to R, which is 0.125 divided by 1 plus 0.125 times by T, T which is 9 over 12. Okay, so we have the answer 0.1143 times by 100%, so which is equal to 11.43%. In number 2, so same. So now the interest rate is 8%. So find the bank discount D. So D is equal to 0.08 divided by 1 plus 0.08 times by 9 over f. So we have the answer 0.0755 times by 100%. So we have 7.55%. Alright, so next question, number 8. A 110-day promissory note dated 31st August 2003 with interest at 6%. So simple interest has a maturity value and with interest at 6%, simple interest has a promissory value of 4073.33. So on 12 October 2003, so the note was discounted and the proceeds received were 4019.47. So find the maturity date, face value, amount of the note, the term of discount and so on. Okay, so lakar dulu, tulis dulu. Okay, so sini we have the note dated on 31st August. And then 12 October 2003, the note was discounted. So here lah. Okay, 12 October 2003 discounted and the proceed received is 4019.47. Okay, so find the maturity date. So cari tarikh hujung ni. And here is S. Here is face value. Okay, so first find the maturity date. To find the maturity date, so we have here 31st August plus by 110 day, because from here until end this one is 110 day. Okay, so kalau kita nak pakai yang ni boleh tak? Tak boleh, sebab kita nak cari yang hujung. So macam nak cari tempoh masa ni, sebab tarikh ni pun tak ada. Okay, so we only have the way here 31st August plus by 110 day, and then you will get the maturity date. Okay, so to find the maturity date A. Okay, so we have month, day and remainder. So month start from August. Okay, so 31st August until the end of August, 0 lah, because 31 minus 31 which is 0. So remainder start from 110 day, so still 110 day. And then August, September, so 110 day more than 1 month. Okay, so lebih daripada 3 bulan lah. Sebab sebulan anggarkanlah 30-90 ni, so lebih 3 bulan. So kita ambil September, October and November full month. Okay, so September is 30, October 31, November 30. So total of this one is 92. Therefore the balance 110 minus 92 is 18. Okay, so since we have here another 18 day, so we take December. So for December we only have 18 day, so balance 0. So therefore maturity date is equal to 18 December 2002. Okay, next question, the face value. Okay, so now here we already have the date, so the date is 18 December 2002. Okay, so to find the face value here, so we need to know the maturity value. Okay, so how to find the maturity value? So maturity value kita boleh cari menggunakan proceed. Okay, so given is the proceed, so B proceed. Okay, so proceed received is 4019.47. A for 4019.47 47. Okay, so before that, dah ada dah maturity value dia. Apa saya tak nampak ni. Okay, so has a maturity value. So therefore, S here is 4073.33. Okay, so formula of H, we have S1 minus DT. So 40194 is equal to S, which is equal to 4073.33, 1 minus D, so discount rate, which is equal to berapa discount rate dia? Ya Allah. Okay, so kejap, apa saya cari ni? Okay, sorry. B, find the face value. Okay, so for the face value, so we already have maturity value. So maturity value is 4073 ringgit and 33 sen. Okay, so by using formula of maturity value, which is S is equal to P1 plus RT, so we have S 4073.33, and P we don't know because we need to find. 1 plus R is 0.06, and T is 110. So 110 divided by 360. Okay, so therefore P is equal to 4073 ringgit and 33 divided by 1 plus 0.06 times by 110 over 360. Okay, so the answer is, okay, so you calculate, using calculator, so 3,999 ringgit and 99 sen. Lepas tu kat belakang dia tak ada 62. So round off, you will have RM 4,000. Okay, so C, the amount of discount. So dia nak cari discount C. So we have here S 4019.4. Okay, so we have here S, which is 4073.33. Okay, so from 4073 ringgit and 33 sen, so minus discount, obtain the proceed. Okay, so therefore discount, you can search as S minus by. Okay, so maturity value minus by proceed. So which is 4073.33 minus by 4019.47. So which is equal to RM 53 ringgit and 86 sen. Okay, so next D, the term of the discount. Okay, so D, we know here term of the discount, which is from 12 October until 18 December. Okay, so calculate month day. Okay, so month, which is October, start from October, and then we have November, and then December. Okay, so pada October, from 12 October until the end of October, so we have 31 minus 12, which is equal to 19. Okay, so November full month 30, and December is only 18 day because until 18 December. So total, which is 8 plus 9 17 1 1 2 3 6 67. So therefore the terms of the discount is 67 days. Okay, so now you already have terms of the discount, Okay, so next you can find the discount rate. Okay, so to find discount rate, since we have discount, so discount is equal to 53 ringgit and 86. So formula of discount, so we have DSDT. So 53 ringgit and 86 is equal to S, which is 4073 ringgit and 33 cent. D, we need to find, and T is 67/360. Okay, so sini darab dan sini bahagi. Okay, so therefore this one I bring here first. So we have 53 ringgit 86 times with 360 is equal to 4073 and 33 cent times by D times with 67. Okay, so therefore we can calculate D, which is equal to 53 ringgit and 86 times by 360 divided by 4073.33 times with 67. So we have the answer for the discount. So equal to 0.0710. Okay. So times by 100%, we have here discount rate, which is equal to 7.1%. Okay. So next, F, the interest rate that is equivalent to discount rate. Okay. So we need to find R, which is equivalent to 7.1%. So kat atas tadi ada R, buat apa nak cari lagi? So atas ni, this is R. So R for the promissory note. Okay, so interest rate for the promissory note. But F, we need to find interest rate equivalent to discount rate. So tak samalah. Okay, so how to find? So we use the formula R. Okay, so F, which is R equal to D over 1 minus DT. Okay, so D we have 0.071, 1 minus D 0.071. Okay, T, so macam mana nak guna T promissory note ke discount rate? So we use the discount, bank discount punya term E, which is 67/360. Okay, so which is equal to 0.0719. So 195. Okay, so on this one you can round off, become 0.072. Okay, so times by 100%. So the answer is 7.2%. Okay, so next, last, I think this one last. Okay. Okay, so 160-day promissory note dated 20 September 2003 with interest at 12.5%. Okay, so we have here promissory note dated on 20 July 2003. And then the term of the promissory note is 160-day. And the interest rate R is 0.125. Has a maturity value of, so here the maturity value of 3083 and 33 cent. The note was discounted on 17 September, so here 17 September, with a discount rate of 9.5%. So D is equal to 0.095. Okay, so A, find the maturity date. Okay, so to find the maturity date, okay, so we have here months, day, and here is remainder. So remainder we start from 160. So months from July. So July we have 20 July. So 20 July until the end of July, which is 31 minus 20, which is equal to 11. And then after July, August. Then September. Okay, so before that, we need to calculate the remainder here. So July 11 day, so from 160 day minus 11, which is 149. Okay, so this one 149, I think more than 4 months. Okay, so lebih daripada 4 bulan ni. Okay, so next August, September, October, November. Okay, so August 31, September 30, October 31, November is 30. So total of this one 3,6,1222. And then 149 minus by 122, so we have the balance here. 9 minus 2, 7. 4 minus 2, 2, 27. So therefore for the December, okay, so 27 less than 1 month. So December we only take 27 day. So therefore maturity date is 27 December 2003. Okay. So next be the face value of the note. Okay, so face value here, so which is P lah. So P kita tak tahu. Okay, so P here. Okay, so to find P, since it is given the maturity value, so we use the formula of S, which is equal to P 1 plus RT. Okay, so S is 3.33. P we don't know because we need to find. 1 plus R is 0.125 and T is 160 divided by 360. Okay, sebab dia tak bagi tahu, so pakai bank discount. Okay, so therefore P is equal to 3083.33 divided by 1 plus 0.125 times by 160 divided by 360. Okay, so the answer is RM 2921.05. Okay, so next C, find the proceed. Okay, so C, find the proceed. Proceed here at the middle, H. Okay, so maturity date here is 27 December. Okay, so to find the proceed, okay, so proceed is S minus discount rate, or we use H equal to S 1 minus D, T. So we need S, we already here S, D, so we have D, only T. So we need to calculate T from 7 September until 17 September until 27 December. Okay, so until 27 December. Okay, so first terms of the discount. Okay, so start from 17 September. Okay, so September, October, November and December, months, day. So September, from 17 September until the end of September, so we have 30 minus 17, which is equal to 13. And then October is 31, November is 30, December is berapa tadi? Until 27 December. Okay, so therefore here 7, 3, 10, 11, 1, 3, 3, 6, 6, 8, 9, 10, 101 day. Okay, so therefore proceed H is equal to S 1 minus DT, so which is equal to S is 3,833.33, and then 1 minus, so saya tulis bawah tak muat eh, so 1 minus D which is 0.095, and T is 101 over 360. Okay, so the answer is, okay, so ni saya salah ni sini. Okay. Okay, so 3,083 and 33 sen. Okay, so saya salah titik. Okay, so the answer is RM 3,001 ringgit and 15 sen. Okay, next E. Salah tadi tu C. Okay, so D, the interest rate D, that is equivalent to discount rate. Okay, so interest rate that is equivalent to discount rate. So this one is E. Okay, so D, interest rate R equivalent to discount rate, which is 0.095 divided by 1 minus 0.095 times with 101 over 360, so which is equal to 0.0976. Okay, so times with 100%, so we have here 9.76%. Okay, so that's all for our lesson today. So see you later next time. Assalamualaikum and thank you.